विष्णु चंद्रा इज फॉर्चुनेट टू हैव स्ट्रॉन्ग एकेडमिक बैकग्राउंड एंड डिड हिज साइंस ग्रेजुएशन फ्रॉम DBS कॉलेज देहरादून फॉलोड बाय MSc एंड MTech MPhil इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ रुड़की बिटवीन 1978 टू 1986. ही वॉज इन्वॉल्व इन रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट्स ऑन क्लाउड चेम्बर स्टडीज टू अंडरस्टैंड न्यूक्लिएशन प्रोसेस स्टडी इन थिन फिल्म एरिया एंड डिजिटल टेलीविजन एंड कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम्स. After a long stay in electronics consumer industry, in the year 1986, he joined academics as a lecturer in Department of Instrumental, BITS Pilani, and worked as group leader, instrumentation. He was involved in teaching and academic work in the domain industrial instrumentation and controls, communication systems, and television engineering. In the year 1994, he had taken over as head of a new division on natural resource informatics at NIC Delhi, and this facilitated his journey in the domain of geospatial technology and services. Since last more than 25 years, he is able to establish robust cloud-based multi-layer GIS platform, Bharat Maps, integrating geospatial data and SOI, ISRO, FSI, RGI, and many ministry and departments. He is currently heading several other divisions of NIC associated with Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, Ministry of Power, MNRE, Ministry of Coal and Ministry Environment, Forest and Climate Change. He is also handling National Disaster Management Information System Division and NIC IPR Division. The key projects and achievements are flagship ICT platform initiative includes GIS such as National Power Portal, E-Dharti, Geo Portal, Smart City Projects for Greater Noida, Noida, GIS Platforms, Slum Rehabilitation in Mumbai, Parivesh Platform for Environment, Forest, Wildlife and CRS Clearances.
Okay. See, the topic which was given to me, Innovative Geospatial and AI Applications in Water, Sanitation and Hygiene Sector. And I am going to cover that since I belong to an organization called National Informatics Center, Ministry of Electronics and IT. We are providing ICT platform services to government at various levels of decision making, starting from national level, state level, and district level. So we are not from geospatial data generation side, but we are basically facilitating services for e-governance planning and decision making. So my orientation of this topic will be around that. The presentation flow is as per this slide. The statement of problem covers WASH, National Urban Sanitation Policy, sanitation and environment, sanitation and economic impact, challenges in strategic planning, followed by methodology, ICT, Information and Communication Technology, and Geospatial Framework, Geospatial Data Sharing Framework, and NIC has a GIS platform called Bharat Maps, which is a cloud-based GIS services, which is being used in various governance applications, findings and outcomes in terms of geospatial and water resources, is a case study related to Jal Jeevan Mission, which we are implementing in the state of Telangana, and then way forward in terms of emerging technologies and water resources. The statement of problem, as I said, is as follows. WASH, as a subject, water, sanitation, and hygiene. WASH infrastructure, improvement for toilets, hand washing, and drinking. This is a core aspect of it. Ensuring safe drinking water, cleaning of toilets and floors, critical and general, surfaces disinfection, efficient management of hospital waste, hand hygiene, laundry and personal etiquettes, ensuring availability of consumables like soaps, cleaning and disinfecting material, facility improvement planning based on gaps accessed, duty roster of services regularly updated and monitored. Now, all of these problem definitions have a geospatial context which has to be addressed. and various government schemes which relates to rural as well as urban, whether Swachh Bharat Mission urban, Swachh Bharat Mission rural, or there is a Ministry of Rural Jal Jeevan Mission has a Department of Drinking Water and Sanitation. All these programs, all these schemes deals with these aspects. And in all these aspects, geospatial technology and services of NIC are being used. National Urban Sanitation Policy Program, there are three tiered implementation strategy. There are national level guidelines of Government of India, state level sanitation strategy, plans and targets, and then city level sanitation plan, which is dealt by urban local bodies, and long-term as well short-term plans. Now, for cities, Swachh Bharat Urban Mission deals with Swachhata Sarvekshan, even ranking of urban local bodies in terms of sanitation aspects, creation of the assets like toilets and so many things, sanitation infrastructure, and those assets and other things are geotagged on NIC's GIS platform. Now, this is what happens real time, and data flows through NIC network in all these schemes and programs to in fact, they here along with geospatial AI is also being used for what you call verifying the locational accuracy of toilet built, its linkages with beneficiaries, and since beneficiary link incentives are there for creating the sanitation infrastructure, those things are monitored based on geo AI concept and based on verification validation system supported by GIS and AI, the incentives to beneficiaries is directly given through DBT system. National Urban Sanitation Policy Program has these components which deals with awareness generation, monitoring and evaluation, financing, capacity building, knowledge development, and institutional mechanism and roles. Now, if you see in this country, sanitation and environment, these two have an economic aspect of it. They are interconnected regime. Say inadequate sanitation is costing about 2.5 trillion Indian rupees per year, and maximum impact it has on health related aspects, because you see 71% or so plus has it is impacting the health conditions. There are domestic water related problems, 7%, excess time spent, because there are a lot of time spent in accessing the resource. There is an impact on tourism also. Here I say, particularly in this slide, if you see health, water and sanitation and hygiene, they are interconnected. But in current context, if you see the Government of India information systems, there are multiple verticals and silos. Say drinking water quality survey is done by Department of Drinking Water and Sanitation. Health survey is done by Ministry of Health. Connecting these two databases, say how waterborne diseases based on water quality parameter can be defined and can be put on geospatial platform and linked with health conditions, or say because of excess or deficiency of certain water quality parameter, chemical parameter and bacteriological parameter, what kind of health and hygiene hazard can happen in a particular location. If these together can put on GIS platform, then you can plan your hygiene and sanitation and health infrastructure. So different vertical silos of Government of India dealing with different databases and surveys should be integrated on ICT platform with geospatial framework. So this is what, if you want to connect sanitation, health and environment, all the verticals, all the ministries and department and their information system has to talk to each other. these are the challenges. One is challenge number one is the speed, because time is going and we have to cope up the space of urbanization. That is, urbanization is going on very fast. So there are challenges related to reforms, institutions, skill developments, and asset. So these challenges has to be addressed. Challenge number two is sanitation requires not only sound technical solution, but good governance, social and local political context. How you involve people, what kind of processes of good governance, interconnecting various stakeholders you can create. Wide range awareness among all stakeholders, because there are interdependencies in terms of various stakeholders, interdependency in terms of data, in terms of information, in terms of requirement of implementation. So third is challenge number three. We cannot replicate what is happening in Europe or America or any other country, because of there is a lack of money, even lack of water resource. There are large number of country which in terms of groundwater potential, they are in a dark zone, and lack of energy and lack of reuse orientation. So you need to create sanitation, reuse infrastructure should be in place. So Indian context, Indian problem statement, Indian technology, Indian solution. So that should be a very, which is replicable across the country in different environments. So these are the challenges. The strategic dimension of good city sanitation plan is fivefold. One is solid waste, governance and institutional strengthening. Now, solid waste management need a good infrastructure in terms of picking up from the right location, movement of it, and its treatment. So come entire from source to processing of solid waste for further use for good things, that requires a proper infrastructure and skilled resources at grassroots level. We are doing this kind of things in a smart city projects for say good Greater Noida, where a vehicle which are carrying solid waste are being monitored on real time on large scale base map or geospatial platform. Complete tracking from source to a solid waste plant, complete tracking of vehicle and movement is tracked, and entire process workflow process is defined with location specific information, and so that city will remain clean. Similarly, water supply, it needs finances. You have to create a water supply network and a efficient set network. And again, in this aspect also, the routing of water supply network and all that has to be on a GIS platform. Storm water management, it requires capacity enhancement. Access to sanitation services and facilities. This is a challenge, strategic dimension is, it should be inclusive. All sector or domain of society should have access to sanitation facilities. Wastewater management has a strategic dimension in terms of technology. Technology means there are emerging technologies like IoT sensors and all those things clubbed with geospatial things and AI can be used for wastewater management. Now, initiative by government towards water sanitation hygiene, ICT and geospatial framework and geospatial data sharing framework, Bharat Maps, which we have an IC as a GIS platform. This slide gives complete picture what National Informatics Center is doing. NIC's mandate is we are the technology partner of government, providing ICT infrastructure on demand. ICT infrastructure covers cloud services, email, SMS services, services like data center services, video conferencing services, and so many things. And in addition to what application development, cloud, and all that we are providing. design and develop IT system for government. We are providing large number of ICT platform services. Explore and advise on use of emerging technologies. So this is what the mandate of NIC. We have a national cloud called Meghraj, which is extending services to in government. And then apart from that, we have a platform called Open Government Data Platform, which is being created to implement national data sharing and accessibility policy of 2012 of Department of Science and Technology, where a lot of data and services are published so that any app developer can use it for his applications. Now, this open data platform in view of new geospatial policy is being enhanced, enriched in terms of spatial data also. This conceptual diagram shows how a geospatial enabled data sharing framework is facilitating systems of systems for e-governance planning, including things in water resources. This framework conceptually shows we have a cloud ICT infrastructure. At top of it, we have a cybersecurity framework for secured communication. At top of it, then we is the 3D mapping, land property card related services for Swamitva scheme. So can all these data sets for common cause should talk to each other, work in an interoperable manner around common special reference framework. So this is what NIC we are trying to do, and we are trying to achieve in many areas single window systems for common cause of development. So WASH-like problem statement, which is currently dealt by multiple department, multiple agencies at central and state level, which is governed by multiple vertical databases, should talk to each other for common cause of sanitation, hygiene, and eco-friendly development at grassroots level. So this is what the direction of this diagram. The BharatMap platform is a multi-layer GIS platform, web services comprising of seamless country-wide base maps, satellite images, hybrid maps, aligned as per global geospatial standard, OGC standards. It is an essential component of Digital India program to ensure easy, effective, and economic governance. The base map service can be user specific. We have large number of point of interest, point cloud data, data-driven mapping, mobile friendly mapping, web friendly mapping is facilitated through this platform. We are also giving in government map as a service to be integrated by various application developers in their own native applications. This platform has All India base map starting from say 50,000 scale reference to 10,000, and satellite imagery from 56 meter to say 50 centimeter, integrating base map services from various Indian platforms including Bhuvan, and base map services from global also. Then various data sets coming from various ministries of departments related to point of interest database in terms of schools, in terms of banking locations, in terms of health infrastructure locations, in terms of PDS location, more than 1.5 million point of interest data, providing reverse geocoding and reverse geocoding services on fly, GIS framework for data updates for any government department on demand. You can do some sort of a crowdsourcing or update your, say, water supply network, for example, by involving field agencies on web with navigational services for nearest government locations. This is entire platform is cloud-based. bharatmaps.gov.in. You can see in public, it is a national portal with map service sharing, API-based map service portal, mapservice.gov.in, and portals for every state and UT as stategisportal.nic.in. So this is a comprehensive platform, and from single instance of cloud, map services are being integrated in Swachh Bharat Urban Mission, Swachh Bharat Rural, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, Drinking Water, NREGA, BharatNet Telecom Network, and so many things. So large number of e-governance applications are using these services, and we regularly update, particularly administrative boundaries up to village level, through workflow involving state revenue authorities, Survey of India, RGI, and all stakeholders in the system. Findings and outcomes and case study. GIS and integrated water resource portal must have portable drinking water security on long-term basis to every rural household and public institutions. Functional tap connection to every rural household. Gram panchayats and rural communities to plan, implement, manage, own, operate, and maintain their own in-village water supply systems. Capacity building of the stakeholders. This is the vision statement for integrated water source portal where GIS can also be deployed. This is the components of Jal Jeevan Mission and its role. Creation and update of water supply network infrastructure. This is a primary requirement. Water resources mapping and data management. Water network and services monitoring. Optimal use of water resources and budgeting. SLA management, social audit and grievances. Business analytics for decision making. This helps effective, timely and efficient collaboration, problem solving and decision making with the appropriate geospatial water resource data content standards covering all aspects of utility infrastructure, water quality, they will build data, they will build geospatial maps related to water supply network and various technology solutions, starting from mobile app for data capture, web-based system for geospatial analytics and visualization, and backend checker and maker system for data capture, its validation, and further reporting of the output. Now, all this thing, see, mobile system, web system, and people, they have to work in sync. So this is what ICT provides to all stakeholders of Jal Jeevan Mission. This is one of the slide where dashboard is shown, and this map is coming from Bharat Maps platform on the Jal Jeevan Mission portal. So this map services are going real time. There is no physical transfer of data. Means I'm not sharing data or moving data from one server to other server as a shape file. The map service is going from one, getting integrated in multiple system through OGC compliant map services. And these are being called in the same JavaScript or Python code by the developer who are coding MIS information also in the same software code. So this is what the approach is. This is the requirement of special data sets and research requirement for such water supply system, water assets and infrastructure, intake wells, reservoir tank and storage, treatment plants, distribution network, water supply to every home, water testing laboratories, IoT devices for location, for machine to machine transfer, from sensor to sensor transfer, real time, water quality, chemical, bacteriological, water resources, surface, groundwater, quantitative assessment, water related management and decision support information. Mission Bhagirthi is being implemented in the state of Telangana. with an objective, this is a case study, to provide functional household tap connection to every rural household. This is the primary objective. Prioritize provision of FHTCs in equality affected areas, villages in drought prone, desert areas, Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana villages. So there is a prioritization of providing this tap connection to every household based on certain conditions. So that is also being programmed. Provide functional tap connection to schools, Anganwadi centers, GP buildings, health centers, wellness center, and community building. Now, you see, for third objective, the geospatial data related to school comes from school GIS. Related to Anganwadi centers, it comes from ICDS GIS. Gram Panchayat buildings come from Gram Manchitra portal. Health center location comes from Health GIS. Now, this is what the power of ICT infrastructure and sharing of the data through API. So this is what NIC is facilitating. Then fourth is monitoring functional tap connections. So how it is operating, where is the, if some problem occurs, how to rectify. So real-time monitoring of tap connections, maybe through IoT devices, through sensors. Bringing awareness of various aspects and significance of safe drinking water and involvement of a stakeholder in a manner that make water everyone's business. Six, empowering and developing human resources in sector as per the demand, short-term as well long-term. Assist in ensuring sustainability of water supply system, water resources, water supply infrastructure and funds. Promote, ensure voluntary ownership among local community by way of contribution and incentivizing labor and voluntary labor. So this is what the objective of Mission Bhagirtha. This is mobile application for tap water survey of residents. So this is a GIS based mobile app which has been provided for data collection, and Bharat Map services are also embedded in these mobile application. So this is what, for each asset capturing residence information. So this is what has been happened. Data visualization, network analysis, segment Godavari Pusuru. So this is what using various asset location, complete network planning on GIS platform. This is again a data visualization web interface for analytical dashboard of monitoring, structure-wise statistics, network coverage details showing in a card format. Some kind of water supply network card is also being given as a part of dashboard. Water grid connecting habitations, complete state-wise analysis and creating water grid network on GIS platform for various districts, mandals in Telangana. These are the activities, further activities in pipeline. Integration of GIS and SCADA system to provide display of special data on maps of water utilities, distribution network, besides the operational information in real time. So this is, there are already SCADA systems related to water supply network. The integration with GIS, it is being in pipeline. Second is a spatial analysis, a statewide network grid rendering especially to depict water flow, various assets created under the project, habitations and beneficiaries covered. Third is a breakage monitoring system. If some infrastructure gets and to take appropriate action for restoring the water wastage, so to avoid wastage of water and through timely maintenance. So these are the activities under planning. This is what, how source to the household connection. These are the various assets and route which is being there, and each of these source, location, intake structure, treatment plant, sump, ground level storage balancing sump, and overhead balancing tanks, overhead reservoirs. All these locations are being captured as a part of geospatial platform. So from source to household connection, each location as a part of network is on map. Way forward in terms of emerging technology and water resources. Use of emerging technology, what you call GeoAI, GIS plus artificial intelligence together. And Bharat Map is a core spatial reference framework. Artificial intelligence and IoT for real-time information capturing. GeoAI with IoT can be used for water resource quality, data capture, spatial analysis, demand and forecast. For building efficient water system, comprehensive distribution network, infrastructure planning for water structures, optimizing current water resources. GeoIoT tools, which you call emerging technology sensors, real-time decision-making at the measurement and monitoring location. So this is what IoT device, machine-to-machine transfer can be facilitated. Data quality, improved data quality, and overall consistency. Once machine-to-machine data transfer is happening real-time, there is a very little chances of fudging of the data. Configuration remote configuration capability. We can configure these devices sitting from maybe a command control center and maintain it. There are sensors, meters and sensors being intensively applied to regulate different activities of water distribution system, such as hydraulic pressure, flow, water quality, head losses, and water and energy consumption. So these sensors facilitate real-time information on and with location to be integrated on GIS platform. Water information convey prompt, reliable, and information secured water meter information to avoid any potential damages, foresee expected disaster, leakages, and provide accountability. These are the some of the areas which I'm just listing: spatial machine learning, data cleaning, normalization, missing value identification using spatial machine learning data sets, quantitative to qualitative data conversion, like water quality index. You can do through machine learning and processes you can define. Advanced AI generating consolidated quality assessment, qualitative assessment based on parameters across selected stretch. You can do the validation of assessment reports. There are special tools to synchronize water supply with demand, regulate pump operations to save energy. GIS tool in agriculture developmental health activities helps to improve the network and hydraulic design of irrigation system. Possible elementary software applications include water head losses, calculation during flowing water in pipes, which can be, means these are the areas where collaborative work with water resource expert and IT expert can be done together. Advanced software application to simulate water flow in complicated loop of water networks and facilitated optimization of pressures, flow, and irrigation system. GIS tool can facilitate computerized irrigation water budgeting system based on soil type and water retention capacity, climate condition, crop water requirement. These are the emerging technology as well as research area where ICT community and water resource community can work together to facilitate that. Monitoring and disaster warning systems. These are also with respect to rains, flooding, and breach of water courses, which can be where AI and GIS system for behavior predicting and modeling, risk assessment and warning services can be used appropriately so that with due coordination and with due system of governance and from national to local level with appropriate infrastructure. Thank you. So this was my last slide. I just want to say that, see, collaboration, cooperation among various stakeholders to take maximum benefit of ICT and geospatial system is the need of our. When I say geospatial is what by default, or geography by default, is a science of parallel processing, where with respect to common piece of geography, multiple events, man-made as well as natural events, occur simultaneously. Science of AI, data analytics were there more than 50 years ago also. And science of image processing was also there, where supervised classification, non-supervised classifications of images we used to do in even 70s, 80s, 90s. But we are not able to take benefit of AI and AI implementation with respect to location because of lack of computing power. And computing was sequential. Geography by default is a science of parallel processing. Computing was sequential, and lack of capacity in terms of storage of data, in terms of capacity of computing system, in terms of RAM and speed, in terms of network speed, were the limitations 25, 30 years back. Today, with supercomputing and increase in capacity of computing power, which is day by day is increasing, it is possible to process large data in a real-time manner. Today, you must be seeing on Google Map how traffic density, how rainfall, how congestion is mapped almost real-time. So real-time information from various locations are being streamed through sensors, through various heterogeneous devices, survey devices like drone and UAV. And those information now has to be streamed on geospatial platform almost real time and processed, analyzed, where AI algorithms to be used to churn out change detection like analytics and so many analytics at top of it. So this is now becoming a reality. We are able to take benefit of even old algorithms of image processing with a large computing power, large network speed in real-time basis. So science of GIS or geospatial is science of where. Science of what you call IoT sensors, UAV drone is you can call is a science of when. AI data modeling and analytics is a science of what. So we have to create using ICT a system integrating science of where, science of when, and science of what for common cause of, say, challenges of, say, like area like water, sanitation, and hygiene. Thank you.